Well, 2 years ago, a group of Lowell residents who are minorities filed a lawsuit against the city alleging that the method of electing city councilors and school committee members violated the U.S. Constitution, also the Federal Voting Rights Act, by diluting the vote of the minority community. They specifically said that the vote for nine all at large method of electing councilors deprived the minority community of a fair opportunity to elect members of that community to these governing boards. Well, the settlement gives the city council four different options for methods of electing councilors that differ from what we have now. The first is to split the city up into nine districts. Each district would elect one city councilor. The second is called the hybrid model, which is a combination of district and at-large. Right now we have nine at-large, means every councilor represents the entire city. With this hybrid system, there are a couple of sub-choices. One is in eight districts with one at-large. Another would be eight districts with three at-large. Now that would mean adding two additional councilors, would go from 9 to 11. And the third option is seven district councilors and two at-large. So that's the hybrid system. The third one retains the all elected at-large, but it changes the method to vote to, rather than a winner-take-all, to what's called proportional representation. That's also known as ranked choice voting. And in that way, the voters would cast their ballots and would also vote for nine candidates for council, but they would number their choices 1 through 9. And the one that would really count is whoever you voted for number one. And that, if that person either won by a wide margin or lost by a wide margin, then your number two would get your vote. And so that would not require any redistricting of the city. It wouldn't change the size of the council, but it would change the method of counting the votes. And then the fourth and final one, it's a combination of some districts with proportional representation. And I think what it contemplates is three districts, each electing three city councilors, but all would be elected by proportional representation. By September 3rd of 2019, the council has to choose two finalists from among those four I just described. And those two, the council would convene public hearings and have people speak out what they would prefer. And the settlement also contemplates the council placing the two finalists on the ballot this fall, November of 2019, in a non-binding referendum. But then finally, by December 3rd, the council has to pick one of the two finalists to be the system that the city would ultimately use in 2021.